So hello everybody, welcome to Mountains for Everybody channel. I'm here in a beautiful forest on my hiking tour and I'm using Osprey Atmos AG LT 65 backpack. So I wanted to say a few words about this series, LT series that they have launched for the season 2023. The backpack which I'm using here, you can see it, is a 65 liters. They also have Atmos AG LT 50. And the same is with the versions for women. So you have Aura AG LT 65 and also 50. So this is a new subgroup that they launched last season. I shall explain later the meaning of the words LT in the name, but before that I shall show you the backpack itself. Just to mention that you have officially four backpacks in the series, as I mentioned, but each of them comes in two sub sizes, so you have actually eight backpacks. For example, this 65 comes in the volume of 65 and 68 liters, so different volume, and also this means different torso range. So I'm going now to find a good spot where I can put my camera. So before showing you the features of the backpack, first have a look at it when it is fully loaded, almost fully loaded. So what I have here is all my stuff for sleeping outdoors, which means I have tent, sleeping bag, sleeping pad, inflatable pillow, warm clothes, and food and water. Well, I have also a waterproof layer. The weather is good, so I will not need it. But anyway, it looks maybe big, but it's only around 10-11 kilograms or 22-23 pounds. So it's close to half the recommended weight for this backpack. With such a weight, it is okay. I'm not sure how it would be if I would load it to 40 pounds as it is, or 18 kilograms as it is recommended as the maximum. I have seen some people complaining that the hip belt doesn't work great if you load it and carry very long distances. I can confirm a bit about this here. There is this part on the hip belt which cuts me below my hips. But we are all differently built, so it doesn't mean that it wouldn't work perfectly for you. So it is essential that you try actually the backpack before you buy it. Try it with the full load and then you will get some feeling. Of course, you can never know before making many kilometers with a heavy load. Okay, I have removed most of the stuff from the backpack, so just to have a look what I have here. I hope I shall be able to show you clearly. So you see, I have my Ferino solo tent, sleeping pad. This is Crua outdoor sleeping bag. I have also inflatable pillow, and this is a liner if I need it. So most of the things are outside. So I will start with the suspension system and the back panel, because this is the best part of this backpack. So if you need a backpack with a ventilated back panel, this is it. You will not find anything better. There are many backpacks on the market from several brands with ventilated back panel, but you have here something more. If you know this industry, you will know probably that Deuter started this, I think 1998 or something, with their Deuter Futura series. My first experience with this design was in 2003 when I bought my Deuter Futura 38 backpack, which I still have. And much later, some other brands started making this design. And here you have it example from Osprey, and it is the best possible. The reason for claiming this is that you don't have only the back panel ventilation, but you have also hip belt ventilation. You see, when you spread the hip belt, magic happens here. Tension is created in the mesh, and you also have mesh here that separates the hip belt from the body. So all the way from here, behind the shoulder harness attachment, to the lumbar zone and to the hips, you have ventilated structure. So again, if you want ventilated backpack, this is it. The torso length here is adjustable, and I have released it just to show you how it works. They use here a ladder type system with 5 separate slots, so you can choose very easily. You see, if I choose this position, I simply do this and it's in place, and then I do the same on the other side. And now it is locked in place. So it's simply very efficient. Of course, you have several different positions, and the remaining tuning you can do with these straps on the shoulder harness. Hip belt is again something incredibly good. You have not only adjustment of the torso length, but you also have adjustment of the hip belt padding, and I hope I shall be able to show you. You see, there is Velcro here, so you simply break it. I'm keeping my camera, so it's not so convenient. So you simply break it and then move the hip fins forward or backward to your position. This is the position which is good for me, but if you have a bigger body size, then you will simply move this forward. One detail that I really dislike are those straps. Just have a look. They are incredibly long. I have around 60 centimeters here. So far too long for me, but again, for people who have bigger body size, this will be perfect. So this is about the suspension. Just to mention that it is supported with this wire. It is 4 millimeters. I think it is steel, and it goes around the perimeter in the all the way here to the bottom of the backpack. And I think this is why some people complain that this part actually cuts into the body. So again, we are all differently built, and it's important to try the backpack yourself. This is a top loading backpack, so you have a lid which is removable. It is floating type lid, which means you can leave it at home if you don't need it. And in this case, they have added these flaps here that are equipped with buckles, so you can close the backpack even when the lid is removed. They fit the straps and buckles that are on the front of the backpack, you see. And the inner is one deep compartment. You see, when I put hand, it goes all the way to the bottom, so there is no bottom compartment here. So you have top access, and there is also one side access here, which is J-shaped. I hope you can see it here. This is the zipper with the entry point to the main compartment. So, 2 access points to the main compartment. The backpack is, of course, hydration compatible. There is an inner sleeve for a bladder, and then there is attachment point here, and there is an opening that goes here behind your neck. you can see it here. Regarding the pockets, I shall start from the lid, where you have one gigantic pocket with a zipper. It's really huge. My stuff is still inside, I didn't remove it. Then on the front, you have this front pocket with a buckle. My jacket is right now inside, so it's convenient to have it, to put stuff that you need on the go. And on the sides, there are two huge side pockets. I didn't remove the bottle here because I wanted you to realize how deep this pocket is. This is a 1.5 liters bottle, and you cannot see it when it is inside. So two side pockets, and you also have two pockets on the hip belt, zippered of course both. When I walk, it is sometimes difficult to unzip with one hand, but anyway, they are very large, and of course I love to have them. Regarding the attachment elements, you have plenty of them. So there are four loops here on the lid. With a piece of cord you can attach stuff on the top. You have the usual side compression straps. This is the one that goes over the side pocket, as you see. And the same is here on the other side. Then there is the upper compression strap here, the same on the other side. You have several additional attachment elements. There are two loops here on the bottom of the backpack. Let me show you from this angle. So two loops here on the bottom, and you can then combine them with these upper compression straps if you want to attach trekking poles or axe or something similar. And there are also, of course, these compression straps on the bottom, so you can carry some extra stuff here. The backpack comes with the rain cover, which is in a separate pocket on the bottom. So a few words about the letters LT in the name of this backpack. My understanding is that this should mean light, and this backpack LT is lighter, 220 grams, than the standard Osprey Atmos AG backpack. Now let me show you which features are missing here. I shall start from the lid, where in this backpack you have only one pocket. In the standard version you have two lid pockets. On the front you have this pocket, but standard backpacks have also two separate zippered pockets on the front. This backpack has one side entrance. The standard AG has two side entrances. Then there is no bottom compartment, as you realize here, and you have this in standard AG backpacks. And most importantly for me, you don't have stow on the go attachment system for poles. Of course, if you don't use trekking poles, this is not important for you, but for me this is important. So this is around six features that are missing here, and they have reduced the weight for 250 grams for this backpack and 150 grams for the backpack 50 liters version. So this backpack weight is around 4.2 pounds or 1.9 kilograms if I remember correctly, and from my calculation this is, the weight is reduced for 8%. On Osprey site they claim the weight is reduced 10%, but in any case you see this is not a substantial reduction of weight. This backpack is in the range of I would say mid weight backpacks. The actual feeling when you have it, when it is empty, when you have it in hands, is it doesn't really look heavy, doesn't feel heavy. Anyway, I shall stop here my review, and I'm going to pack these things and continue my tour.